Hi, I'm Sanjay Pujare, and I have been at Google Cloud for more than 4 years, where I've been working on gRPC. I have been a lead for Proxilus gRPC security and Proxilus gRPC with Istio. I have also worked on gRPC Java, traffic management, and observability.
And I'm Vindhya Ningegowda. I'm a software engineer on the gRPC team at Google Cloud. I work on gRPC and have been working on observability.
So what's this session about? I'll start off with gRPC for microservices. How gRPC has become a foundational technology for microservices. I'll then dive into observability, especially in the context of microservices. Vindhya will then talk about the gRPC observability product that recently went GA. In the past, a large monolithic app could have multiple teams working on hundreds of thousands of lines of code compiled into one binary. This led to long and difficult build processes, big failure domains, and difficulty rolling out changes due to the coordination required. In the microservices paradigm, the same app is instead made up of many of smaller binaries called microservices, each serving a much tighter role and communicating with each other over the network rather than through direct function calls. But microservices introduce some complexity. You have to define and maintain interfaces between your client and server, and you have to maintain stateful connections between them. gRPC solves both of these problems for you. In this picture, the blue layer talks to the red layer, which talks to the yellow layer, and these RPCs cross network and infrastructure boundaries. The regions shown here could be any infrastructure segment where RPCs have to cross these boundaries. But let's look at another aspect of microservices where effective use of this paradigm could be hampered by a lack of observability. Observability, in simple words, is visibility into the internal goings-on in your microservice mesh to the extent you need that visibility for reliability and efficiency. For example, if something breaks in your complex mesh or is performing poorly, how do you figure out where the problem is? And how do you fix the problem? How do we get back what we lost using the microservices paradigm? Is there any way the infrastructure or the software components can provide the required visibility? This is where gRPC observability comes in. So what is gRPC observability? The gRPC observability product consists of three pillars of observability: logs, metrics, and traces. We use the gRPC interceptor framework to inject our observability interceptors, which generate the raw data for the three signals: logs, metrics, and traces. This part is then integrated with exporters and backends so that the raw data is processed and sent through the exporter pipeline to an appropriate analytics backend. This end-to-end integration is what we call gRPC observability. Let's take an in-depth look at the use case. You have an app developer, the character on the left in green, maybe that's Vindhya, building gRPC applications using the latest gRPC artifacts supporting observability. The running apps are provided with appropriate observability configuration by the developer. The gRPC interceptors pump the relevant raw data, logs, metrics, and trace information through appropriate exporters into the respective backends. Here you see a logging backend, a metrics backend, and the traces backend. The backends produce the required dashboards, which are used by the consumer. In this case, the DevOps engineer, to get visibility into the internal state of the application, focusing on gRPC traffic. gRPC observability runs in Google Cloud. On the producer side, it has plugins for logging, metrics, and traces. On the producer side, you also include the required exporters in the app, specifically the stack driver exporters for metrics and traces configured to send data to the Google Cloud Ops backend. For logging, the gRPC observability code directly calls the cloud logging APIs. All of these are currently available in Java, Go, and C++, with more languages coming soon. The product also has an admin console to enable and administer the feature. And then we have consumer dashboards that provide some popular canned views and allow you to customize them with customizable queries. At this point, I'm going to hand it over to Vindhya for the rest of this presentation.
Let's see how this works with gRPC Java. There is a Java artifact called gRPC GCP Observability, which you use in your application. This artifact pulls in all the dependencies required to produce and export logs, metrics, and traces. In your Java app, you call the observability gRPC init function at the beginning. When the application is run in Google Cloud and the appropriate configuration is provided, it automatically sends the required raw data to Google Cloud Ops backend. Just by adding a line to your application, you have observability into your services. It's that easy. Let's look at this Java code snippet for an actual example. In your application class main method, you call gcpObservability.gRPCInit to initialize observability. Based on the configuration, observability data will be generated and exported. Instead of writing 1,000 lines of code, gRPC makes it easier for you to have visibility by adding just 2 lines of code. So what are you waiting for then? Start using gRPC observability today. As Sanjay said earlier, observability is available in Go. Let's look at the Go code snippet, which is similarly simple. In your application main method, you call observability.start and pass in a context to start observability. Data will be generated and exported based on the configuration. Note that observability.end is called to end observability. C++ follows a similar flow to Java and Go for setting up observability. In your application main method, GCP observability init should be called before any gRPC channels or servers are created. Observability will be set up based on the configuration provided. You can see how easy it is to instrument applications with observability in Java, Go, and C++. With just a few lines of code, you turn on the magic of gRPC observability. We have been saying observability requires a configuration. Now we will take a closer look at the various components of the configuration. Observability configuration is specified as a JSON file and with certain environment variable to point to that file. Alternatively, configuration can also be specified by setting the JSON config directly as value for an environment variable. As you can see, 3 pillars of observability can be independently enabled or disabled. Let's look at each independent component of the observability configuration in detail. Even when microservices are distributed across various projects, you can have your observability data unified in a single project for better visibility and analysis. This can be accomplished by specifying project ID and making sure the project in which your microservices are running has permissions to write logs, metrics, and traces to the project ID specified in the config. To enable monitoring, all you have to do is add cloud monitoring object. It's that simple. This is what the gRPC observability configuration for traces looks like. As we know, trace data is often produced in large volumes. In order to reduce the overhead, probabilistic sampler configuration is available, which allows you to specify the sampling rate for the trace data. In this case, with the value of 0.05, only 5% of calls are randomly selected and will be used to generate trace data. This is what the gRPC observability configuration for logging looks like. For logging, there are filtering options to limit or filter the kind of client or server RPCs you want to log. Wildcard can be used to specify all methods of a service instead of listing all the methods explicitly. Labels specified in the configuration will be attached to all the enabled signals of observability. They can also be used to provide extra identification information, such as the application's version, the type of environment, and so on. Let's say you have multiple components like databases, GKE clusters, and client applications, which are emitting logs. and suddenly you start seeing errors all over the place. Now you want to aggregate logs across the components. When you try to filter, lots of unrelated data or messages are interleaved, as shown in this example. To find data related to certain RPC is like finding a needle in a haystack. In order to address this problem, gRPC observability attaches labels to observability data. When you want to see if the latest changes are causing the spike in errors, all you have to do is add build version in your observability configuration, and all of the logs emitted across components will have the same build version, which will help you filter and find logs of interest, which will help you in debugging. This is an example of a log record showing the resource and custom labels attached. We automatically attach resource labels which identify location or source information of where the data was generated. It can be the VM name, the Kubernetes cluster name, or the namespace. The custom labels contain environment and source version as supplied by the user's configuration. To summarize, gRPC is becoming a foundational framework in developing applications in general and microservices in particular. Because developers have come to depend a lot on gRPC, we think this foundational framework needs to provide the required level of support for users of gRPC. And we believe gRPC observability is a great way to keep your microservices or distributed applications healthy and happy. And we are also very excited to announce that gRPC observability is generally available. The details of everything we discuss can be found in the gRPC observability user guide. It also includes examples to help you get started with observability. We also have a blog that talks about gRPC observability and how easy it is to integrate with your existing applications. gRPC.io is a great starting point to get more information about gRPC. Now that you know how to configure and instrument your applications, we have a follow-up video titled Observability Visualization for gRPC Microservices in GCP. It's a great presentation to learn how to visualize and analyze gRPC observability data. If you're looking for an easy-to-use and reliable way to keep your microservices or distributed applications healthy and happy, then gRPC observability is a perfect solution for you. Thank you again for your interest in gRPC observability. We hope you find it a useful tool for your work.